You know, this is pretty cool. This little demo that I downloaded off of Microsoft's. I don't know if I'm still on it though. Yeah, right here. You know, which is actually from their .NET, you know, developer code samples. So, you can see what the URL is right there, more or less. If you want to try to type that cryptic thing in. At any rate, basically, it's just a bunch of shape windows and XAML. So, but, you know, what's nice about XAML, because you can do shape windows with regular Windows forms, right? But the thing is, you can't really see the shape of the window until you actually run the code. So that's kind of annoying, you know. But, you know, if you need a shape window for, like, a splash screen or something like that, this would be a cool thing to do it in. The thing is, I don't know, you know, this is a WPF application. And, you know, while I can add a Windows form to a WPF application, you know, if you look at Windows Forms here, you know, I can actually add a Windows form to it, no problem. But I don't have all the same options that I do with a Windows form control. Like, for example, you know, I have graphics selection down here, and I don't, you know, in a Windows form, but I don't have that option here for some reason. So I know there's some differences between the two, and I know I can't seem, in a Windows form, I can't seem to add a XAML type page. So, you know, if you're starting a forms project, you may not be able to add a XAML, you know, form to it, you know, for lack of a better word. You know, maybe you can, maybe it's just more complicated, but I know the reverse is true. I can certainly add a form to a XAML project, but, you know, the other way around may not work. But, you know, anyway, this has several different types of, you know, forms that it demonstrates. And, you know, this one is for pictures, so, you know, you can download a picture, but, it, you know, you should have a transparent background. So these are PNG format pictures. And it kind of gives you instructions here, you know, on how to, you know, how to add your own pictures to it. So, you know, kind of like right here, or here, you know. So, but anyway, it's pretty simple, and you know, the program doesn't do much, you know, but it just pops these forms up here. You know, so you can go like rounded rectangle window, and you can move it around, and what the fuck happened? Why the hell did that happen? Shit. What a bunch of fucking bullshit. Shit. Fuck. Oh, god damn it. Tell you, Windows 10 really takes the fucking cake. And give me Windows 7 any fucking day. I mean, what a piece of total shit. You know, shit like this constantly happens. Like, you know, this morning, you know, Visual Studio was like always on top mode, and I couldn't, you know, I had to shut it down and fucking restart it when I brought my computer, you know, jiggle my mouse so my computer would start up. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to fucking stop it now, aren't I? Since I don't know where the goddamn program is. What a piece of shit. Yeah, I do not like Windows 10 at all, by the way. I mean, I've been, you know, using this for about a year, but I fucking hate it. You know, it's a real step backwards. I mean, even the interface sucks. I mean, again, give me Windows 7 any day. So it's like it's, You know, that's why I had to go out and get a 4K monitor, just so I can get my icons to look kind of normal size. You know, so I can have more than like 12 of them on my fucking desktop. So, I mean, it's fucking ridiculous that I had to go through those measures just to have my goddamn computer look and operate the way I want it. Anyway, getting back to the fucking topic at hand, from whatever the fuck that was, cocksucker, you know, there's always a new surprise every fucking day with Windows, I'll tell you. And it's not a good one, usually. But anyway, you know, you do have these different XAML windows you can pull up, and I guess you can have more than one of them up at a time, and, you know, and have them overlap, and, you know, and even this picture window pulls up this thing with text, but it's hard to select. But, anyway, pretty cool. Well, hell, I guess those aren't child forms, so. Okay, well, anyway. You know, and by the way, you know, I just, that's what this is Blend. You know, and I just simply said, you know, design and blend, and brought this up. So it's just really like a XAML editor, you know, which is a little fancier. You know, I could see this being beneficial. I never really used it before, so I don't really know what the snot's going on with it, but but it does look pretty feature rich, you know, in terms of what you can do with it. Maybe a little better than working in Visual Studio with it, but, you know, you are just dealing with XAML code here, I think. So, I don't know how this interoperates with Visual Studio, but I don't know, it's pretty neat looking. Let's, yeah, we'll do that. Put another deal here. Make a little more yellow. Okay. Then I'll just, I don't know, go save. Close. And save all. Okay, I'll just close that thing. Okay. File has been changed externally and has no unsaved changes inside this editor. Do you want to reload it? Yeah. Let's go ahead and reload it. I'm probably changing the original code, but I still have the zip file, so I'm not worried about it. Okay, so. Okay, yeah, there are the changes, so. Let's see if anything looks different, because I don't know what all these things are. Okay, yeah, we can see our see our little object. Like I said, I still don't know how to get rid of this damn thing. So, like I said, it seems to show up in release and everything else. But, anyway. So, pretty interesting.